Halifax police repeatedly violating my human rights, written by Daniel J. Towsey, a truth soldier, September 11, 2012. Thank you for reading this. I am now going to show you what it is like to be disabled and in a wheelchair in the city of Halifax. Also, please note that this is the third time that the Halifax City Police are violating my human rights and preventing me from accessing public property based on the Protection of Property Act. This and other events of the Halifax Police violating my human rights have been ongoing for many years. Ever since I departed from Toronto in 1984, where I ran a federal election campaign for lawyer Michael Cohen, who is running against Bob Kaplan, the Solicitor General of Canada. There has been numerous very serious events done against me by the police ever since. Bob Kaplan created Canada's secret police known as Canada's Secret Intelligence Service. Then Bob Kaplan gave them their first covert case. He put a contract on me to be destroyed. Bob Kaplan said to me that, "We are going to destroy you. We are going to make you so destitute that you will have to resort to crime to survive. And when you do, we will put you in prison where we will have our fun with you." So at that time, no one in the country knew or had ever heard of the secret private interest police that does not answer to we the people's laws, justice system or courts. Canada's Secret Intelligence Service is a very scary evil organization that has been covertly attacking and destroying freedom and justice-seeking activists ever since. You may want to read my very first article I published on the internet in 1999. Corrupt Canadian Elections Vote Fixing. This series of banning me from public properties events started when I testified to the corporate media and published an article about the police behavior on the Halifax waterfront, about my witnessing the drowning and death on the Halifax waterfront of a man during the Halifax International Buskers Festival that I was filming in August 2009. Please read this related article, "Man Drowns at Halifax Buskers." Then a few months later, on November 22, 2009, the Halifax police were involved in an attempt to murder me. Please read my article entitled, "How to Assassinate a Cyclist." Then later the police again interfered in my human rights by applying a Protection of Property Act restricting me from the publicly owned Dartmouth Sportplex where I was photographing the Canada Games events. I wrote this article about that, and I also filed a complaint against the Halifax police where it was found that I never did anything wrong. Please note that I had been doing physiotherapy twice a week for the previous year at this locating due to the injuries I suffered from the attempt on my life. Please read my related article, "Beautiful Girls at Canada Games." Then the next event of the violations of my human rights is when the police again falsely applied the Protection of Property Act when they banned me from all Halifax public transit buses, ferries and properties. This was over the bus driver refusing to let me off the bus at the Dartmouth bus terminal. Please watch my testimony about this event videos. Bus driver refused to let wheelchair user off the bus. Please note that after the 6 months ran out on the order banning me, many bus drivers have since repeatedly harassed me, and I videotape many of these events. So that I now almost never use public transit. So I am limited by the range my electric wheelchair can travel and the weather. I since had to move out of Dartmouth and go to live in downtown Halifax. Also, please watch these videos. Halifax bus driver refuses to secure my wheelchair properly. And also, bus driver harassment, November 4th, 2011. There has been many more incidences that I did not videotape. So after you check out these above previous events, it is very obvious that the local police and government have been repeatedly terrorizing me, which falls under the new anti-terrorism laws that were enacted across this country since the events of 9/11. So under those laws, not even the police or government members are immune from prosecution for domestic and civil terrorism against me. When are my human rights going to be protected? When is justice going to be done? Never is what I believe. Nova Scotia, like Canada, are now fully under the control of Zionist New World Order corporations that pretend to be the people's governments. We the people have no governments. We have no representation. We have no governments that write laws protecting our individual rights. The fake governments only write laws to favor other corrupt corporations. If you would like to read my political activist articles about Canada, then please go to my Canadian Situations WordPress website. I will now explain to you the ongoing battle that all wheelchair users face in trying to have accessibility and how the city of Halifax mistreats and violates the human rights of the disabled that have to use a wheelchair to get around. Below you will also see supporting videos about this issue. I hope that after you read this and view the videos, you will telephone the authorities to express some support for my situation. I will provide you with names and telephone numbers. This event started earlier in the summer. It relates to Salter Street, which is the only street and sidewalk that connects to the Halifax waterfront boardwalk, where I spent most of my summer doing photo shoots and folk videos of performers and buskers, as you can see at my Folk Photographer YouTube channel and my Daniel Towsey Photoshop site. Being in a wheelchair means that the only socializing I can do is outdoors, since most properties in Halifax are not accessible. This means that I cannot visit any friends. This also means that I spend more than 8 months of the year imprisoned in my home. Going to the waterfront is a very important social event for me. I have been doing videos like these on the waterfront for more than 5 years. The problem is that the Halifax Waterfront Development Commission thinks it has the right to block the sidewalk access at the end of Salter Street so that I have no way to get on the waterfront unless I drive my wheelchair through private properties. I almost never ride my wheelchair in parking lots. It is way too dangerous, and drivers when backing out cannot see me in my wheelchair. I ended up in a wheelchair because I was run over by a driver almost 3 years ago while riding my bicycle. So now I am seriously injured and disabled. I am very afraid to drive around cars. My other option to get to the waterfront is to go down a fair distance on Lower Water Street, but the sidewalk on that section is made of bricks and it is all uneven, very bumpy, and has holes where bricks are missing, plus it has a lot of very busy driveways. It is too painful for me to use that poorly maintained sidewalk. So getting on the waterfront at the end of Salter Street is my best option. Please watch the videos about the fence blocking the sidewalk and the third video showing my complaint about it at the Halifax City Hall. You can go to my YouTube channel and see all the videos in the playlist entitled Wheelchair Rights. See videos about Salter Street was being blocked by a fence. Salter Street obstruction, Halifax, Nova Scotia. Note, the City Hall ignored everything and never dealt with this problem, and so it continued. This time there was the lady security guard there. I asked her why they are allowing them to block the right-of-way access to the boardwalk on the waterfront. The waterfront boardwalk is federal jurisdiction, as all shorelines of Canada are, and the boardwalks are built and owned by the federal government. So the provincial statute banning me has no authority on the boardwalk. The power-tripping security guard was very cold and nasty and cared not one bit about my access either to complaint or concerns. She really upset me, so I just used my wheelchair and moved the fence out of the way and went to the boardwalk. Again, I tried to speak with that security guard woman and she just did not care and told me so. She also told me that it matters not at all to her what my concerns are and did not want to hear anything. So I told that I was not going to speak to her and I went on my way. Over the next 3 weeks, many times when I was on the waterfront, that security guard was shadowing me. It was obvious she was looking for an opportunity to create an incident. Which brings us to yesterday, where she indeed did cause an incident by harassing me and interfering in my freedom to do music videos. Yesterday I was doing video of Braden Benham, who is from Ontario. Braden is not familiar with the situation on the Halifax waterfront and the too often harassment by the security guards. He was told he was not permitted to busk. Continued below comments. Have a look at this short video entitled Braden Benham, 4, Stopped by Security. Reader's comments about this video. Marcel Othbeset says, gonna share your story. You broke no law. Are you under legal personhood? Did you show identification? Either way, their contracts are fraud, but it's tough to get them to admit that in court. I'll share your story though, one man protest. Daniel J. Towsey says, stay tuned, I am writing a lengthy detailed article about this and why this happened. I showed him ID but I did not sign anything. Marcel Othbeset says, here, start here, I could explain, but I don't have the time. All you need, fill your boots. D. Study your freedom here. Note, please go to text version of this report for the hyperlinks. Nothing to it, just watch video links. listen radio links, read newspaper links, study or read document links. That is it. Enjoy. It is your freedom. No one can give it to you. You must claim it, and before it is too late, if you do, you help end the suffering in the world. Namaste. Daniel J. Towsey says, thanks. Will do. I am very familiar with the free man on the land, but that won't be much of an option with these criminals here who think they have authority over everything. Marcel Othba said we are not freemen on the land. Look at our identity document. We are a whole new bread, unregistered, unincorporated. We have done it, so can you. Maybe not for this case, but anyone can do it. Namaste. Daniel J. Towsey says, great stuff. I will be including this comment thread in my article so others can learn too. Marcel Othbeset says, please do, we are teaching what we have done already, to the world for free, even if you never join us. Peace. Dominic S. Gross says, I admire your cause, Marcel. Namaste. I live in the USA, and am interested in learning about your society. I imagine there are differences between our systems, but I believe there to be many similarities as well. I doubt the possibility of this working in the States. Daniel J. Towsey says, the problem in this world is that we are dealing with a criminally insane New World Order corporatism. So no matter what we do that is civilized and just. The insane just keep killing and destroying all that is true and beautiful. Winged Knight says, well, when you show up in court they will not show or they will have to drop it. Daniel J. Towsey says, I do not think so. This place is run by Freemasons. There no such thing as justice system here. Cops and everyone else in the government lie about everything. Winged Knight says, trust me, stand up for yourself and fight it. If you don't fight it, then you cannot win. I had about over 1,000 in tickets from a dick cop who tried to stick it to me. I went to court and they dropped it all. I believe in you. Daniel J. Towsey says, oh, I will fight it. But now every time I go to the waterfront they will harass me. Marcel Othbeset says, both are nations, are in fact corporations, with business addresses in the USA. It is almost identical. Unregistered, unincorporated is how you explain it. It is how we talk to the bank about our society. Thank you for your interest and support, Dominic. You are right, Daniel. Long run our society will bond our own peace officers, with full rights to stand up to any corporate agent committing fraud in how they do their jobs. Just won't be for a few years. Our programs first, then public support, then we peacefully change things. We have strategies to do this, without shooting any bullets. And our side anyway. Daniel J. Towsey says, I love it. It is great to hear something positive being done. Thanks. Daniel J. Towsey says, so I went on the waterfront today, September 13, 2012, and the police came and harassed me again and gave me another $275 fine for being on the waterfront. Now they want to arrest me. Remember, I have done nothing. YouTube viewers comments. Marcelly Bissett says, next time try to record more if you can, of both the security guard and police. You have every lawful right to video evidence anything on public property. Peace. FolkPhotographer says, thank you. Stay tuned, I am writing a lengthy article about this. It will be posted at Wheelchair Rights WordPress. There is more to the story than what you see here. This security guard was out to harass me and not Braden. Where you will see that we were not causing any problems, and you will see the security guard come stand in front of my video, and the rest of the story continues below. Which is why I am writing this article, and this is about my wheelchair and human rights. Braden was not aware about my previous encounter with this rude and overbearing security guard that is on a power trip. So this security guard tells Braden a bunch of dictatorial lies, and Braden, being the nice guy he is, just went along with it all and started to pack up. Then the security guard starts to walk away and I start talking to her and asking questions. She rudely told me that she had no interest in being civil with me or to answer any of my questions. She refused to listen to me, so I spoke anyway and told her she was wrong. She continued with her tyrannical power trip attitude and then grabs her shoulder microphone and starts spewing out her misauthority crap to whoever she was talking to. We could hear her exaggerating and lying, and I could not be bothered with her. so Braden and I went far down the boardwalk and set up. As we went away, I told him she is probably calling the police. As it turns out, I was right. So the police show up and the security wannabe police officer has a 30-minute conversation with the officers. I could not hear what they were saying. The police then come to me and give me this notice that under the Provincial Protection of Property Act, I am now banned from the whole Halifax waterfront. Meaning that they are banning me from a huge public area. A whole section of the city. How can such a thing be legal? This act is a violation of my human rights. We already have laws to deal with situations, so how could anyone in government ever write such an act that gives security guards this overreaching authority? Just what are they protecting? I did nothing wrong except speak up for my rights against a tyrannical power tripping overbearing security guard. I told them that I did nothing wrong and that they should be ashamed of themselves for harassing a guy in a wheelchair and violating my human rights to go out in public and on a public sidewalk being the boardwalk. They did not care. Remember that no business or property owners on the Halifax waterfront ever made a complaint about me. The two police officers never investigated by not speaking with me or Braden. The police just spoke with the security guard and never spoke with me. The police were unreasonable and do not care for truth or justice. They act like we are in a police state where individuals have no civil or human rights. Reader's comments on YouTube video, Winged Knight says, well, when you show up in court they will not show or they will have to drop it. Daniel J. Towsey says, I do not think so. This place is run by Freemasons. There's no such thing as a justice system here. Cops and everyone else in the government lie about everything. Winged Knight says, trust me, stand up for yourself and fight it. If you don't fight it, then you cannot win. I had about over 1,000 in tickets from a dick cop who tried to stick it to me. I went to court and they dropped it all. I believe in you, Daniel J. Towsey says, oh, I will fight it. But now every time I go to the waterfront they will harass me. End of comments. So the police officer told me I am banned from the waterfront boardwalk, so I moved to the concrete area. But I told him I was not leaving and that they had no right to violate my human rights, especially since I never did anything wrong. So the police gave me a trespassing fine of $275. Then the police departed. The next day I went to the Provincial Justice Minister's office and had a discussion with Fred Sanford, Director, Policing Services. He gave me a copy of the act and nowhere in the act does it say that it applies to public areas or sidewalks, nor does it apply to federal properties. It is a provincial statute. Fred was surprised about what was going on and agreed with me that this provincial statute does not apply to the shoreline of Canada that is federal property. My next stop was at the Halifax Police Station to file a complaint about the first two police officers for not doing a proper investigation by not questioning me or Braden. The police were lied to by the security officer and the police did not care. My complaint is that the security guard is guilty of giving false information to the police, which is a criminal offense. I also expressed to the complaints officer that the police are peace officers and not penal officers. They are not permitted to force penalties on anyone. That is only done by a judge of the courts after a trial. The Property Protection Act is unlawful and unjust. I also said that the police need to let justice take its course by my having filed my notice with the court of my disputing the fine imposed on me. I then requested that the police cease any harassment against me until this situation is taken to court. I also asked the police to go and get a statement from Braden before he returns to Ontario, which he will do very soon. After this meeting I went to the courthouse and got a trial date for February 2013. So then a couple of days later, being yesterday, September 14th, I met up with a group of musicians and we went to the waterfront to a busker's stage. On the way I told them about what had occurred. They all acknowledge having had separate previous problems with that security guard. The performance was going well and they had an audience sitting on the bleachers. We were there for a couple of hours and the performers told me that the police were approaching behind me. So I went towards the police and they said to me that they were called because they said that the waterfront security had been there earlier and had asked me to leave. I told them that no security had been there and that they never spoke with me. I then asked the performers if the security had been here, and they all said no. Then the police got into a discussion with me talking about being banned. I told them that I had no understanding as to where I was banned from and that the paper I was given did not indicate where the boundaries or limits were. I also said that the previous officers the other day indicated that it meant the wooden barred walk. Since the whole shoreline comprises of many different private properties, I believed that I was permitted on the concrete or asphalt areas that were private property adjacent to the barred walk. I indicated to the police that all this harassment of me they were doing was based on lies after lies by the security and the police, and that their coming here based on more lies showed the pattern. They told me that the security spoke with me, and again, like every other time previously, I told them that security has never ever spoken with me. I got really frustrated with the police not willing to reason anything, and I told them I no longer wanted to speak with them. Then I moved away from them and just sat there in my wheelchair observing the performers on the stage. The police then gave me another trespassing fine of $275. One of the performers that had been listening to me and the police went over to speak with the police. After some time, he comes over to the stage to tell us that the police said they were going to arrest me, handcuff me, and pull me out of my wheelchair and throw me into the paddy wagon. He told the police that would be very inhumane considering that I am severely disabled and have numerous skeletal injuries from having been run over by a car. He was shocked that the police wanted to injure me, a disabled person in a wheelchair. So all the performers and I departed. The police did not arrest me. So today, September 14th, I filed a formal complaint against the Halifax police. Please go to the text version of this article for more updates. See link below this audio video transcript.
Thank you for listening.